back to my channel. My name is Okay Mom. We're just gonna get rid of that. I can't deal with this. You know what? I'm just gonna take this off. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Here's a little look I came up with for Dia de los Muertos. It is very simple. All you need is a lot of patience. Things you need are a color palette that I got at Party City. You can get at any Halloween store. Any sequins of your liking, any rhinestones of your liking, and really you can use any eyeshadows you have at home. And I really like these colors right now, pastels. I have pinks, purples, whites. I threw it all in there. Usually the original colors for the Dia de los Muertos, it's either red, orange, any of the basic primary colors. But I did my little take on it and I used all these colors. So if you would like to know how I achieved this look in my intro, then keep on watching. So I'm gonna start with a white eyeliner that I got from Maybelline, and I'm just going to trace right underneath my cheekbone. And I'm gonna connect those two lines from the cheekbone and trace right over my chin. It's okay if you mess up and that line kind of gets out of place, just because we are gonna use the white face paint to color in those lines anyway. Here I'm drawing a web on my forehead that you'll later see that I didn't need, so that's why I'm speeding right through it, because it's irrelevant. This is a palette that I got from Party City. It's just a face paint palette with a few colors, and I'm going to paint right within those lines. It's okay if the color starts to look a little streaky and muddy. We're gonna fix that in just a bit. And you wanna make sure you don't get the white right on the eyelid, because we're gonna go over with a different shadow and face paint color anyway. And we're gonna fix that muddiness with a beauty blender. And we're just gonna pounce away just to blend everything. That looks so much better. I'm gonna grab my Carly Bible palette and I'm gonna use the lightest highlight shade, which is a light pink, which I'm gonna use to set all of my face. This color is perfect because it goes with that iridescent look that I'm going to use with the sequins and rhinestones. Really, you can use any highlight, light highlight, and make sure it's on evenly. This is an eyeliner that I got with a face paint palette, and I'm just gonna use it to outline my eye socket. And I'm using the top of my eyebrow to make it easier and to help me guide through the top of that eye socket. I'm doing it on both sides, and it's okay if it's not perfect because we're gonna cover it with another face paint anyway. And I'm gonna use that lavender, purple, bluish color from the face paint palette, and I'm going to paint right in that eye socket. Make sure you put a little extra on your eyebrows, especially if your eyebrows are on the darker side, just enough to cover it evenly. And you just wanna put this on the outer corner because we're gonna put an eyeshadow on the lid. Same technique with the beauty blender to smooth all the colors out. And I'm gonna use a pressed pigment from ColourPop. It is in color Too Shy, and I'm gonna put that right all over my eyelid. And you wanna get it just a little higher than usual. There we go. See, I put a little bit right above my crease, and this is a shadow from MAC. It is color Deep Truth, and I'm gonna use that on the outer corner of my eyelid. And I'm just packing it on too, just so my crease is way defined and it looks like my eye socket is actually going deep in. I'm gonna use the light purple from the Carly Bible palette. I'm not sure if these have any names, I don't think so, but I'm using that lighter purple to diffuse that dark blue, and I'm gonna put it underneath my eye too. This is a black liner from Maybelline, and I'm going to tight line my eye just on the waterline.
I'm just fixing some of the face paint that I wiped off. This is a smudge brush from MAC. I'm just gonna use that to smudge out, and I'm using Deep Truth to smudge it out. This is my Kat Von D liner, and I'm gonna create a very dramatic wing. You'll see that I'm gonna switch to a gel liner, which I'm gonna use from ColourPop. It is in color Swerve. I switched because I realized that although I really like this liner, it's not sticking so well on that face paint that I put on. There we go. This is a wing liner brush from MAC, and like I said, I should have used this from the get-go, but I'm just fixing that liner because it was coming on so patchy. These are from Coco Lashes in Goddess. I really like these lashes, and they're pretty dramatic too for this look. Fixing my eyeliner. So I'm using that dark purple from the Carly Bible palette, which I'm going to set all around my eye. Before I did this tutorial, I thought I wanted a blue shadow around my eye. That's why I use that light blue. But you know, things change, so I use that dark purple all around my eye, and you're just gonna keep blending until it looks smooth. I'm using a blending brush from MAC. It's MAC 217, and I'm gonna put that right in my crease, that black shadow, just to define it a little bit more, and on those inner corners. Here comes the fun part. These are assorted sequins that I got from Michaels. There's big and small ones, and they're iridescently colored. And I'm gonna stick on, I decided, with eyelash glue, but you'll find that I switched over to liquid latex. It honestly worked the same, but since my liquid latex was a much bigger size with a much bigger brush, it made the process a little faster. So these sequins, I'm not putting in any particular place. I'm scattering them anywhere, but if you look closely, I'm putting the bigger sequin and then two smaller ones on the side of it, just so it looks more uneven. That's what I was going for. And in these gaps, pretending I have a diamond earring, I'm putting those rhinestones in those gaps. I would say these are more a small to extra small size. I got these assorted as well. So I'm putting bigger rhinestones on some parts and the smaller rhinestones on some parts. I'm layering the rhinestones and sequins as well. And you can put these on in any place of your liking. Yay, and other side was done. So I'm gonna get that black liner that came in the face paint palette, and I'm just gonna use that to outline my nose. The nose is pretty easy. It's like drawing out a M, and one side is a little bit more pointier and skinnier. You can draw your nose any way you'd like. Sometimes people do a thinner nose, but since I have a bigger nose, I'm gonna follow that. That liner wasn't as pigmented, so I decided to use my ColourPop gel liner. That looks so much better. I'm also getting it in my nostrils. I'm not picking my nose, just so it looks deeper. To give my nose a little bit more dimension, I'm sorry, before I do that, I'm gonna set my nose with that black shadow. The liner is already pretty matte, so I really didn't have to do this, but since I'm putting more shadow aside from the black one, I decided to put the black. So I'm gonna get that purple shadow and go around my nose. And then that light pink in the same palette from Meet Matrimony to give it way more dimension. So this is a black liner that I got with a face paint palette. This doesn't have to be very pigmented. It's just an outline for the teeth. It's okay if they're not perfect because we're going to cover it with rhinestones anyway. But for me, I wanted to do the little outline so I know to map out where I'm going to put the rhinestones. And I'm just going to shadow out to those lines so they don't look like straight up wiggly lines. You don't have to do this part, but like I said, I wanted to map it out. Which soon to find that I shouldn't have. You'll see why after I'm done putting on my two front teeth. These are just large oval rhinestones. And this is why I said don't put on your mouth. I had to learn the hard way. I guess the latex doesn't stick well to oil-based face paints. It was sticking really well on my eyes, but I guess since my mouth's a little bit more curvier, it was harder to stick on. So they're the same oval, and then the bottom teeth are little circles. I would say they are medium to large size. Same Carly Bible palette. I'm gonna use that dark purple to put right inside my lips. And I'm just adding more of that highlight that I may have wiped off. Nothing special. You're not missing anything. All right, so these are two colors from MAC. I'm gonna use the colors to contour. I'm sorry, I actually used three, which I didn't show. It was in a little pot and it's all broken. And if I would have picked it up, it would have been everywhere. I'm sorry. My voice is going away. So it's gonna be three shadows from MAC. One is Moon's Reflection, which is a light blue. Beautiful Iris, which is a light purple. And Nocturnal, which is a dark purple, which I'm putting directly on that cheekbone to contour. And I'm gonna use Moon's Reflection and Beautiful Iris around that contour just to give it a little bit more dimension. I'm just redefining that line, and from that I'm just gonna do a little squiggly line growing from my cheekbone. Really, you can do any design coming up from your cheek. I don't want to do too much since I already have so much rhinestones and sequins on my face. I don't want to do a lot of writing over that. That white liner wasn't as pigmented as I wanted, so I'm going in with that face paint and just going right over it, just to darken it up a little bit, or lighten it up since it's white. So right by my nose, I'm gonna start doing these little, I mean, they kind of look like less than, greater than symbols to me. So I'm gonna do that right aside. I guess the mini whiskers. And over top, I'm going to put some rhinestones right over that. I'm sorry, not rhinestones, sequins. So I'm putting two bigger ones and then side by side, same technique I did around my eye, two smaller ones. And I'm just kind of giving myself a pink helmet around my face. Like I said, that web was irrelevant. This is why, because I decided to put rhinestones. So this is a iridescent extra large gem that is a heart gem put right over top. And I'm going to put two teardrop gems side by side to make it look kind of like a forehead piece instead of a head piece. All these rhinestones came in one pack, so it's not like I bought some specifically. It was just an assorted pack. I divided all the smaller circular rhinestones in one and then the larger one. So as you can see, I use the larger ones on my mouth and on my forehead. And I'm layering some sequins right in between those little cracks we have between the bigger rhinestones. And I'm just adding more rhinestones to my liking. The more, the merrier. I guess I decided to put some on my chin too. This is why I did a voiceover, because I winged this tutorial so much. I knew if I talked through it, I'd get nowhere. So, square rhinestone, and on the side of those, I'm putting two big sequins. And next to those two big sequins, I'm putting a smaller rhinestone and a smaller sequin. Really, this is all about layering. And I'm done! Yay!
All right, there you have it, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this video. I really enjoyed making it. Like I said, you need a lot of patience, but I think it's well worth it at the end. I took about a couple hours. So other than that, I would love to see your take on Dia de los Muertos sugar skulls. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up, and I'd love to see you next time.